Lord.
Hallelujah. We give you praise.
Deborah, good morning, Tanisha, everybody as you join. Good to see you all. Bless this Sunday morning to you. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. It's good to be back with you. I hope that I have enough light in here. It looks a little bit dark. It looks a little bit dark to me. Let me know if you can see me. Good morning, Susie Q. Good morning, Esmeta. Everybody, as you join, this looks a little bit dark. I'm just trying to make sure you can see me. I'm not sure why, but to God be the glory. I am live, and you are alive to join me. God bless you, everybody, as you join. Hallelujah. This morning, I want to just minister to you about breaking negative cycles in your life. Good morning, Tanisha. Thank you for the compliment. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Go ahead and share the live, people of God. I need you to share as usual to 10 groups this morning. Blessed Sunday as you join. Please go ahead and share the live. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Go ahead and share the life for me, people of God. I have a word for you this morning. Breaking negative cycles in your life. You don't want to miss that. And anybody who you think needs this word, go ahead and share. Yeah, somebody is saying to me that it looks a bit dark. I'm not sure what else I'm to do to get it to be brighter. I'm so sorry. I'm not sure what else I'm supposed to do. Because I've got my lights on. Let me see if shifting this a little bit will help. Sister Janet, how are you doing? Good morning. Tanya Lawrence, how are you? How are you, sister? Hallelujah. Go ahead and share the live for me, people of God. Go right ahead and share this live. I'm sharing as I speak, so go ahead and help me to share. How is everybody doing? Let me know where you're watching me from this morning. Go ahead and help me to share the live so we can get started. Spirit, have your way. Let me know where you're watching it from as you join. God bless you. It's good to have you. I'm just sharing the live, so I want you to help me to share so we can get started this morning. I have a word for you this morning. It is time to break the negative cycles. You don't want to miss that. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit, mighty God. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
Jane doing? Good morning, Rita. Is that Curly? Good morning. Good morning to you, everybody, as you join me. Just go ahead and help me to share. That's what I'm doing right now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yay. Hallelujah. The rain of the Spirit. We will see the rain. My God. Yay, yay. Spirit, have your way. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. We glorify your name this morning. Hallelujah. We give you thanks and we give you praise. We worship you this morning, God. We lift up your name. The great Jehovah Jireh, the King of all kings, the Lord of all lords, conquering lion. Hallelujah, Jesus. The Alpha and the Omega. We thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 Jesus. God bless you, everybody. Sandra Smith, good morning. Good morning to you, Dennis Mambury. Good morning, everybody, as you join. It's a blessing indeed to be alive this Sunday morning and to be able to come to you with a word this morning. To be able to come to you with a word this morning that will enlighten you. Hallelujah. Good morning to you, Debbie Lewis. As you join, please go ahead and share the live. Diane Winchester, as soon as you come in, please go ahead. I speak a blessing over you this morning and over your household. Go right ahead and share this live for me to as many people as you can. Share inbox, start a watch party, share with at least 10 groups this morning. Let me see you evangelizing. Let us spread the good news this morning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Good morning to you, Nomlet Brown. Thank you for sharing. God bless you. As you share, may the Spirit of God locate you this morning and bless you, bless your household, bless the work of your hands. Good morning to you, Atim Paul. It's good afternoon from the United Kingdom. Good to have you. God bless you. Hallelujah. Where in the UK are you? Are you in London? Where are you? Hallelujah. God bless you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, everybody, as you join. Good morning to you, Sister Yamina Maxi. Good morning, Wendy Hines. Good morning, good morning. I speak a blessing over you as you join. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. You are worthy to be praised, Father. You are worthy to be praised. Go ahead, people of God. I will be starting very soon. Just go ahead and share the live in the meantime. Go right ahead and share this live. Hallelujah. I want to bless you this morning with a word to enlighten you. I want to bless you this morning with a word that will give you insight. I want to bless you this morning with a word that will change your life. It is time to break the negative cycles in your life. Hallelujah, Jesus. So many of you are going through things, negative patterns in your life. Things are happening over and over and you can't seem to understand why. You can't seem to figure out how you can put an end to what is happening. Hallelujah. Good morning to you, Camille Dunkley. So I'm here this morning to share a word with you. It is time to break the negative cycles in your life. Many times we do not get things done. We do not resolve problems because we do not even know the problem that we're dealing with. We don't understand it. So I intend this morning to open your eyes in the natural and in the spiritual as to what may be happening in your life. Why you have certain patterns, cycles repeating over and over in your life. I want to bless you with that word this morning. So go ahead. Good morning, Alvin Murray. Go ahead, Patricia Benton, and share the live. Go ahead and share the live, Pamela Griffiths. Good morning. You're watching from Jamaica. God bless you. Good to have you. Share the live now if you haven't done so. Share the live and let us bless as many people as we can. Good morning to you, Abiola Canterbury. God bless you. Where are you watching from? Thank you, Holy Spirit. It is time to break the negative cycles in your life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Spirit, have your way. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Jesus. Spirit, have your way. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. bless the Lord. I'm coming to you from Queens, New York. Let me know where you're watching from. Good morning to you, Sister Maria Nicholson. Thank you for sharing. Janine Williams, go ahead and share the live, Janine. I need you to share this morning. Share to at least 10 groups. Share to somebody in box. Tag somebody. Invite somebody. Start a watch party. Good morning to you, Mel. Good morning, Chantel Smallings. How is everybody? Christine, you're watching from Jamaica. Good to see you. Good morning, Karen Fresco. You're watching from Guyana. Good morning from Nigeria. Florence Adiola. And Marjorie Campbell, you're in Florida. Good to see you, sister. Hallelujah. Yes, Valkisha, spirit, have your way. Good morning, Lisa Campbell. Good morning to you, Marsha Richards Maron. How are you? God bless you. Good to have you. Hallelujah. It is a blessing indeed to see you all this morning. I take nothing for granted. I'm happy that you're a part of this ministry. I am happy that you are covering the broadcast as usual and covering me. Good morning to you, Sister Phyllis. Thank you very much, Sister Janet Rose. Ayuni Malcolm, how are you doing? How are you? I'm going to get started in a minute or two. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Spirit, have your way. Spirit, take control. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Just begin to praise, people of God. As soon as you come into the live, I want you to begin to praise. Begin to praise and usher in the presence of the Holy Spirit. Natalie Haslam, good morning to you. Is that Harris? Sister Harris? Good morning. Good morning, Nikki White. Good morning to you, Georgia. Sabatier, you're in France. Good morning. Good to have you, Marcia Bennett. Apostle Benjamin, my cover. Good morning. Ajioma, how are you? Good to see you, Debbie Lewis. God bless you, everybody, as you join. Gail Popo, you're watching from St. Lucia. Good to see you, sister. Is this your first time? God bless you. Special welcome. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Yes, hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. We thank you for your word this morning that you will speak through your servant. Hallelujah. Father, we ask for divine covering over this broadcast this morning. We invite your presence, Holy Spirit. Come in and take full control. Bless every person who is watching this live, God, this morning. Make your presence felt in their household. Touch each of them this morning, God, from the crown of their heads to the soles of their feet. God Almighty, you know their needs. You know why they are here. We pray this morning, God, that this word will touch them, that it will change their lives, that it will be an eye-opener for them, that the negative cycles and patterns in their lives will be broken after this word this morning. Father, we welcome you in this place. We thank you, Holy Spirit, for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your mighty power. We thank you for your hand, your steady hand that has kept us in our times of tribulation. We thank you, mighty God, for protection from coronavirus and every affliction, my God, in this time. We thank you for those of us who still have our jobs. We thank you for the jobs that are to come for those who have lost jobs, because we know, God, that you are putting them back out there to work. We thank you for the new businesses that are coming forward for those who have lost their jobs, but you have put them on a path, oh God, of entrepreneurship. I bless them this morning, God, and bless the work of their hands. I speak favor over their lives, over their business dealings. Mighty God, this morning I speak uncommon favor over their monies. Father, anything, God, that is held up in the realms of the Spirit for them, I pray for release this morning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we pray for divine wisdom to be downloaded to your people as they watch this morning. Hallelujah. We ask, oh God, that you cover them. Speak to their spirit. Speak to their hearts. Speak to their minds in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we decree and declare new season upon every person watching this live. Whatever struggles they're experiencing in their lives, I pray right now, Father, that you begin to break them. Begin to break the patterns of negativity. Begin to break the cycles, every bloodline and generational curse over their lives. We ask that you begin to shake them out now in the name of Jesus. We cancel them now by the power of the blood. Father, we speak blessings over them. Replace generational curses this morning, God, with generational blessings in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I call forth right now the bloodline breakers in the families, the ones who are supposed to be the blessing for the family, the ones who are supposed to break that curse. Hallelujah, Jesus. I pray that you will bring them forth this morning. You will open their spiritual eyes so they can see. Hallelujah, Jesus. I pray for grace
greater understanding and deeper revelation this morning as I minister your people. Hallelujah, Jesus. This morning, Father God, we decree and declare miracles over the lives of the people watching. We decree and declare blessings, mighty God. Even if I don't pray for these people individually this morning, God, your presence is so powerful and so strong, as it has always been over this ministry, that just by coming into agreement, just by being here watching, just by believing, your anointing shall be released over this line, my God, for breakthrough. Your anointing shall be released this morning, oh God, for the breaking of generational curses. Your anointing shall be released over this line this morning for financial blessings. Your anointing shall be released over this line this morning, oh God, for breakthrough, for every problem they face. It shall be released this morning over this line for restoration of marriages. It shall be released over this line this morning, my God, for healing in families. I speak it over their lives this morning, God, and I decree and declare that it's already done. It is done. We thank you in advance in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lift up your hands wherever you're watching from and just come into agreement with this prayer. Come into agreement right now and say, I receive. Say, I receive in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lift up your hands right now and just say, I receive. I receive. I receive in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Receive the anointing this morning for breakthrough over your life. Receive the anointing this morning for blessings to flow over your life. Receive the anointing this morning for breaker, breaker, hallelujah, Jesus, over every negative cycle, every negative pattern in your life. Let the breaker anointing come upon you right now. Lift up your hands to receive in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Good morning to you, Ingrid Barnett. Good morning, good morning. God bless you. Thank you for covering the light. Good morning to you, Luminate Shy. Good morning, where are you watching from? Wendy Williams, it's a blessing to see you. God bless you. Good morning, Miriam Shaw. Everybody who is watching, just make sure that you are receiving this morning. If you're a part of this ministry, if you've been following the ministry, you know that when the Lord begins to move, when he begins to move upon this life, I don't need to call your name. Just lift your hands and come into agreement. Whatever it is that is flowing, the oil that is flowing will reach you. The anointing that is flowing will reach you in the mighty name of Jesus. If you come and you lift your faith and come into agreement, things will move in your life in Jesus' name. Good morning to you, Vivian Ramsey. Donna Pinto, how are you? Good morning, good morning. Everybody who is just coming in, Mary Harris, please share this live. Debbie Tito, is it Titon? Please forgive me if I don't pronounce it correctly. The Angel Dacusbert, good to see you. Good morning, Charnetta Gadlin Cole, Allison Sutton, Carol, who is this? Carol Ann Gentile, good morning to you, Bala Krishna. God bless you, everybody, as you join. Camille Dunkley, and God bless you, Carol Smith. Share this line for me, people of God. If you haven't shared it yet, go right ahead and do so now. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Lift up your voices and praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let me just play this song so that I can get started this morning to minister to you. Hallelujah. Lift up your hands, people of God. Lift up your hands and worship. Lift up your hands and worship. Lift up your hands and begin to worship. Begin to usher in the presence of the Holy Spirit. We cannot proceed without letting the Holy Spirit know that he's welcome here. If you want miracles this morning, lift up your hands and begin to worship. Send up your praises, send up your thanks. Begin to lift up the name of Jesus Christ. Begin to glorify him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I see a victory. Hallelujah. Just come into agreement with me right now. Begin to worship. Begin to speak victory over your situation now. Hallelujah. Speak victory over your situation and welcome the presence of the Holy Spirit over this life. Hallelujah, Jesus. I cover you this morning under the blood. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. The battle belongs to you, Lord. Whatever battle you're fighting this morning, negative cycles being repeated in your life, the battle belongs to the Lord. Let me shift this, see if you can see me any better. Still looks a bit dark. Worship, people of God. Wave your hands this morning and begin to worship him. Wave your hands and begin to worship him wherever you are. Begin to worship and to praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. There is power in his name.
Every walking away just you.
Every war he wages, he will win. God is warring on your behalf this morning. I don't know what your situation is, but he knows. I know how the story ends. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Where are my worshipers this morning? Good morning, Miriam Shaw. Good morning to you again. Thank you so much, everybody who is worshiping. Good morning to you, Donna Thompson. Come on, Latoya Russell. Let me see the worshipers. Come on, lift up your hands and wave. Show me the wave. Hallelujah. Show me the wave. If you believe that your victory is here, show me the wave this morning and give God the praise. The battle belongs to you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. Belongs to you, Lord. Worship, people of God. Worship, worship, worship. I need to see you worshiping this morning. Hallelujah. Strong to say. Enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. Hallelujah. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. There's a miracle in store for somebody this morning. There's a miracle in store for somebody who is watching this morning. I speak it over your life right now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. All right. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. People of God, there's a miracle in this room with your name on it. Wherever you're worshiping from this morning, there's a miracle in that place with your name on it. Hallelujah. I want you to believe and trust God for your miracle this morning. Wherever you're watching me from, there's a miracle in that place with your name on it. You just need to claim it. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm going to play this song for you this morning because this is your word. There's a miracle in this room with your name on it. Hallelujah. Come on, people of God. Worship. Worship. Lift up your voice and praise him wherever you're watching from right now. And it's here. Claim it, people of God. Claim it right now. Whatever it is that you're believing God for, begin to claim it right now. There's a breakthrough in this room. It's got my name on it. Hallelujah, Jesus. Praise on it. This is my tambourine this morning. I'm shaking it. I'm shaking it. This is my tambourine this morning. Hallelujah. Praise God. There's a miracle in this room with my name on it. Hallelujah. With Marie's name on it. Speak your name aloud. There's a miracle in this room this morning. Janet's name on it. There's a miracle in this room with Yamina's name on it. There's a miracle in this room with Debbie's name on it. There's a miracle in this room with Teresa's name on it. There's a miracle in this room with Lisa's name on it. There's a miracle in this room with Tanya's name on it. There's a miracle with Kimmy's name on it. There's a miracle with Vivian's name on it. Hallelujah. Speak your name into the atmosphere and claim your miracle. Right, Arlene Small. There's a miracle in this room with your name on it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Put a praise on it now, people. Come on, put a praise on it.
I get somebody to release the praise in this room. I declare that wherever you are, miracles are breaking up.
Come on, people of God, begin to dance. Dance and praise him this morning. There's a miracle in this room with your name on it. With my name on it. There's a healing in this room with Vivian's name on it. Hallelujah. There's a miracle in this room with Donna's name on it. Good morning, Sharon Seymour. Hallelujah. Cycles from off your life this morning, Natalie. Claim up your miracle, precious. Claim up your miracle, Alton McLean. Claim up your miracle, Latoya Russell. Claim up your miracle, Carol Ann, Marjorie Campbell, Novlet Brown, Patricia Rose. Claim up your miracle, hallelujah, Jesus. Anne Marie Collins, Aliza. Claim up your miracle this morning, hallelujah. I'm gonna put a praise on it. I know my mouth is loud, and when I praise, I tear down everything that is coming from the rims of hell. I tear them down. So open your mouth this morning and praise it. Put a praise on it. You want a miracle? Put a praise on it. Open your mouth. This is not about being pretty. I don't care if I look pretty when I'm praising God. Hallelujah, Jesus. I want my healing. I want my miracle. I want my breakthrough. So I'm going to praise him this morning. Hallelujah. Good morning to you, Lammy. Good morning, Trudy Smith. Good morning, Welton Graham. Begin to praise as you come in. Jennifer Stewart, Tanisha Fraser. Begin to praise to release your miracle. As you come in, begin to praise him. Hallelujah. Good morning, Carl Alfie Lang. Begin to praise him. Come on, people of God. I am a worshiper. I am a praiser. I am a prayer warrior. When I tell you to open your mouth and praise, go ahead and do it. When you do, you release the portals of heaven over your life. Blessings will come upon you this morning. Begin to pray. Begin to pray for those of you who can pray in the spirit. Begin to pray. Hallelujah. Begin to pray. Hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, people of God. We are releasing something over your life this morning. We are breaking chains off your life and we are releasing blessings in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm about to begin ministering to you, but I can't start until I play this song. I'm going to play a song for you this morning before I begin to minister. One more song. Hallelujah. Somebody praise him. Somebody praise him. Somebody praise him. Hallelujah. All right, people of God, God bless you, everybody, as you join. If you're just joining, it's good to see you. Let me know where you're watching from. I am here in Queens, New York. It's a beautiful Sunday morning, and it's a pleasure to have you with me. I am blessed by your presence. Hallelujah. I pray that you will be blessed this morning as you join. I pray right now that cycles will be broken off your life. Negative cycles will be broken off your life this morning as you tune in, as you join. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I know I'm here to testify. This is your song before I get into the word. I'm here to testify. Everybody who is here to testify, just begin to type it. I'm here to testify. Good morning, Sister Claudia. Hallelujah. I know some of you don't like reading the scriptures, but I implore you to start reading the scriptures, because when you come on this broadcast with me, I'm going to be reading the scriptures. Hallelujah. Thank you. Come on, people of God, worship Janet Rose from the Bronx. Receive your miracle. I cannot shut my mouth. Jesus, I'm grateful. Yes, Sister Phyllis, you are here to testify. Yes, Vivian Ramsey. Yes, Jennifer. You're here to testify. Theresa is watching from New York. Good morning. Bebe Bacchus, you are here to testify. Stephanie Brady, you are here to testify. Yes, Novelet, I see you. Michelle Thompson Reed, come on now. Wilmot Archer, you're watching from Jamaica. You're here to testify. Lift up your hands and praise him this morning. Sharon Seymour, you're here to testify. Malva Hogarth, you're here to testify. Miriam Shaw says, hallelujah. Patricia is watching from California. Welcome. Good to see you, Nikki White. I. Good see you, Ruth Farron. Yes, you are here to testify. Lord, I praise your name. I lift my voice to sing your praise. You have been so good.
Everybody,
those of you who are watching for the first time, a special welcome to you. I'm coming to you live from Queens, New York. This morning I want to minister to you. It is time to break the negative cycles in your life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. For those of you who have your Bibles, those of you who are using your tablets this morning, there are several scriptures I'll be referencing, but you can type them. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. John 8, verse 36. Whom the Son sets free is free indeed. The book of John, chapter 8, verse 36. That's one of the scriptures I'm referencing for you this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. My God, my God, my King, my rock and my shield. This morning I give you thanks and I give you praise. Hallelujah. Get out your Bibles for me, people of God, if you have them. Jeremiah 32 and verse 18. You can type the scriptures. Jeremiah 32 and verse 18. Hallelujah. So that's John 8, 36. Jeremiah 32 and verse 18. Hallelujah. Thank you, Auntie Paul. Thank you, Donna Thompson, for typing the scripture. Hallelujah. God bless you. I'm turning this music down so I can minister to you this morning. Hallelujah. Turning this music down so I can give you the word that I have for you. God bless you, everybody. May the Spirit of God locate you wherever you are. Good morning to you, Selena Black. Good morning, Allison Sutton. Good morning to you, Miriam Shaw. Shannon Campbell and Nadine Dennis, good morning to you. God bless you. Good to see you. Shireen Dunn, good morning to you, my lady. Jeremiah 32, 18, John 8, 36. Hallelujah. Those are the scriptures this morning that I want to reference as I minister to you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. We worship you this morning, God. We call upon your name. You are the great Jehovah Jireh. There is none like you. There is none like you, Lord. We give you thanks and praise this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. to you all glory, all praise and honor. Hallelujah, 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 Jesus. Thank you, Father. All right, people of God, I don't know. I don't know what that thing is. Whatever it is, I don't know what it is that is keeping you from moving forward in your life. I don't know what it is that is repeating in your life and what has been repeating in your life for as long as you can remember and causing you to feel like a failure. I don't know what that thing is that keeps happening to you and you can't seem to get that breakthrough that you desire. It's like a cycle that keeps repeating in your life. Good morning, Kimmy Miller. Good morning to you. God bless you. It's like a cycle that keeps repeating in your life and you feel helpless. Hallelujah. The Spirit of God impressed upon me last week to just come to you with this word. Hallelujah. And to share with you about these patterns, these cycles, these negative cycles in your life. Things that have been happening, because many of you don't understand why. You don't know why these things keep happening in your life and you just can't seem to get past them. Hallelujah, Jesus. My God. The same thing just keeps happening to you over and over. The same negative things. The same streak of what you would call bad luck just keeps happening to you and you can't get past them. There's a spirit of disappointment and failure hanging over your life, some of you. And it's present in your life for several reasons. Hallelujah. I want to open your eyes this morning. I just want to give you a brief teaching. I'm going to minister to you on breaking negative cycles. I want to open your eyes this morning as to why some of these things are happening in your life. That spirit of disappointment that won't leave you. That spirit of failure that won't leave you. Hallelujah, Jesus. There are three things I want to look at this morning with you. Three things. Three reasons why these things keep repeating in your life. The streak of disappointment and bad luck and failure. Listen keenly, people of God. One, you can write them down as I speak. One is your lack of vision and strategy. You don't have a vision and you don't have strategy. Hallelujah. So number one, the lack of vision and strategy is number one. Hallelujah. Number two, people of God, is the decisions that you make. Praise God. Or the lack of decisions. Because sometimes it's a decision you make and sometimes it's because you don't make the decision. Hallelujah. So that's number two. The third thing that causes you to go through repeated cycles, negative cycles and patterns in your life are bloodline curses or generational curses. Hallelujah. So those are the three things I'm going to touch on with you this morning. One is your lack of vision and strategy. One. Two is decision making. You don't make certain decisions, or if you make the decision, it's the wrong one, a bad decision. Hallelujah. The third one is generational or bloodline curses. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Mighty God. The sins of your forefathers will impact you, the generations to come. The sins of your forefathers. So when we speak about bloodline or generational curses, that's what we're talking about. You don't know what your great-great-grandfather used to do. You do not know what evil covenants they held. You don't know. And sometimes you're struggling through your life and you can't understand why bad luck seems to follow you, why you can't get past certain things. It's because of some covenants that your great-great-great-great-great-grandparents may have held. You don't know about these covenants, but they are impacting your life. Hallelujah. They are generational curses. Mighty God. So I want to go deeper for you this morning. When we talk about lack of vision, when you don't have a vision, you don't have a plan, you don't have a strategy, that's number one. So it's not just spiritual reasons why you may have things repeating in your life. Negative cycles, negative patterns. There are also things that you can control, but you are not dealing with it the way that you ought to. So number one, let us look at lack of vision, lack of having a plan, lack of strategy. Hallelujah, Jesus. Listen, people of God. Some of us, we have dreams. We have a vision, but we don't have a plan. Others, you may have a vision and a plan, but you don't have a strategy. Hallelujah. But what I want you to understand this morning is that God is a God of order. Turn your Bibles with me, or if you have your tablets, 1 Corinthians 14 verse 40. Look at 1 Corinthians 14 verse 40. God is a God of order. Hallelujah. He says, let all things be done in order. Even in worship, God is a God of order. But listen, order also applies to how you run your life, people of God. It applies to how you run your life. It's not just about how you conduct your worship in church. Hallelujah. It's about how you run your life, how you run your business. Listen keenly. Moses, while leading the Israelites through the wilderness, Moses was taught order and delegation by his father-in-law Jethro. Who remembers that? Moses had the people coming to him, a whole pile of people coming to him every day. He was struggling to manage because there were so many people coming to him for counsel. So his father-in-law looked at him and said, Moses, no, it cannot work like that. You have to delegate. So Moses had to put a structure in place. He had to put order in place in order for things to flow smoothly. He had to find other leaders and put them below him who could take some pressure off him. So instead of everybody coming to Moses, they were now being directed to the second tier leaders who would resolve their problems, who would listen and give them counsel. So I'm saying to you that God is a God of order, and it applies not only in your worship, but it applies in your life. It applies in your business, how you do your business. Hallelujah. So people of God, some of you, you will struggle. You will fail in life if you fail to plan. A man must have a plan, people of God. So you must have a vision. And not just a vision, because you can have a huge vision and nothing comes of it because you don't have a plan. So I want you to understand that you need to have a plan to go with the vision. Hallelujah, Jesus. Mighty God. A man must have a plan that he places before God, and God will order his steps. Hallelujah, Jesus. The Bible says a man plans his way, but his steps are ordered by God. Turn with me to Proverbs 16 verse 9 and you will find that scripture. Hallelujah. Proverbs 16 verse 9. You will plan, but God will order your steps. So the plan that you have, it must be in place, and God will bless you. He will bless that plan and he will give you the wisdom to accomplish those things according to his will for your life. Hallelujah. But you can't come before God every day and just begin to decree and declare, I will this, I will that. This is coming off my life. That is coming off my life, and you do nothing else. You must have a plan, people of God. Faith and works. Thank you, Holy Spirit. So don't decree and declare every day and you lie down the same way. You don't move. You don't have a plan. You don't have a vision. You don't have a strategy. You set yourself up for failure. Hallelujah, Jesus. You must have a plan. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. A man must have a plan. If you don't know what you want, you will experience cycles of disappointment, people of God, because there's nothing to motivate you. If you don't know what you want, there's nothing to motivate you. There's nothing that you're aspiring to. When you have a plan, you organize yourself, you put things in order because you are aiming for something. Hallelujah, Jesus. When things are not in order, you will experience disappointment. You will experience failure. Hallelujah, mighty God. Listen keenly, people of God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We must be able to function in the spiritual and in the natural. Because man is a spirit that lives in a body and has a soul. So many of us, we are highly spiritual people. We pray every day. We speak in tongues. We make up a whole heap of noise. And we cannot adjust to the natural world, the natural environment around us. We are powerful in the spirit, but we can't live out there. We can't survive because we don't know how. So I want you to understand this morning, that is one of the reasons why you may have cycles of disappointment and failure in your life. Because you're overly spiritual, but you cannot adapt to the natural. You cannot function in the natural world. Hallelujah, Jesus. Some of us are Christians. We are powerful in prayer. We are powerful people spiritually. When you go to work, you meet hell, because guess what? You're not disciplined enough in your workplace. So you have a lot of problems. You don't get promoted because you're a tongue-speaking Christian. But when you go to the environment where man is, that's a natural environment you have to adapt to. You don't know how to be disciplined. You are not consistent. These are things that will keep you back, people of God. These are things that will cause cycles of disappointment and failure in your life. You must be able to adapt to the natural world just as how you are powerful and adaptable in the spirit. Hallelujah, Jesus. Listen, people of God. Sometimes we are on fire in ministry. Sometimes we are on fire in ministry. We have this great call upon our lives. And we live and we breathe the things of the spirit. But we struggle when we are put out there to function. We struggle when we are put out there to exist. Hallelujah, Jesus. That is why you find, listen to me keenly, people of God. This is why you find men of God who are anointed, but they cannot thrive outside the church. They're anointed, but they cannot thrive outside the church. They struggle to earn a living, so their marriage is in trouble because the wife wants to leave. Because even though he's a pastor, he doesn't have no money, he doesn't know how to earn a living. So the wife is struggling to deal with it. So they have problems in their marriage. They can't afford to buy a house. They don't have any savings. I have seen this so many times. They are powerful in the things of the Spirit, hallelujah, but they have no idea how to be successful outside of ministry. Mighty God. Many men of God are out there like that. Powerful in the Spirit, speaking tongues 24/7. But they don't know how to earn a living. They don't know how to be a good husband to their wives. They don't know how to take care of their families outside of ministry. Hallelujah. They don't have a plan for their lives. They don't have a plan for their families because they have been taught to preach well. They have been taught to do deliverance. They have been taught church protocol, but they have no clue how to function outside the walls of the church. And then you say that there's a demon attacking you. Why you keep having the same problems over and over? It's not no demon. It's your lack of planning. It's your lack of vision. It's your lack of strategy. Hallelujah, Jesus. They know the word, but they fail to apply the word to their lives in a practical way, people of God. Come on, somebody. They excel in ministry. Good morning to you, Apostle George. They excel in ministry, but they struggle in their personal lives because they don't have a plan for their lives. Listen, the scripture tells us that we should write the vision and make it plain. Come on, people of God, go to Habakkuk 2 and verse 2. Habakkuk chapter 2 and verse 2. It tells you plainly in the scripture, write the vision and make it plain so that it can be executed. Write the vision and make it plain. Every man must have a vision, people of God. And from that vision, he develops a plan. And to realize the plan, he must have a strategy. Are you hearing me, people of God? Let me repeat it. Every man must have a vision. From that vision, he develops a plan. To realize the plan, he must have a strategy. Hallelujah. He must know how he's going to get where he needs to be. Prayer and faith are awesome, but work must go along with it. And not just work, people of God, but organized work. Organized work. That is where strategy comes in. For you may have the you have a grand plan and it's never accomplished because you don't have a strategy. A man must have a plan that is backed by a strategy. I told you earlier about Moses and what his father-in-law did. His father-in-law said to him, delegate. So Moses may have had a vision of how he would do things and how God wanted him to do things. But he did not have a strategy. So everybody was coming to him and he cannot manage everybody. So his father-in-law looked at the situation and said, hold on, Moses, no. Get some people below you, train them, and let them handle some of the people and take the pressure off you. That is strategy, people of God. If Moses had continued along that line, if he didn't delegate, he would have been physically exhausted. He would have been a mental mess. Hallelujah. People of God, listen keenly. Without a plan, you're going to experience cycles of disappointment in your life. Then you're going to start praying. Yes, Father God, I have seen it happen so many times. You are in control of the forces at work in your life. You can do something to change what is happening, but you don't do it because you don't have a plan. You don't have a vision. You don't have a strategy. And then you start praying and you start canceling generational curses, which are not there. So you get up every day and you cancel the curse of poverty when all you need to do is have a plan and get up and do the work. There are no demons at work behind the scenes. No demons. What is happening is you fail to plan. So no demon, not in the background stopping you. Hallelujah, Jesus. But you're busy blaming the demons. You're blaming demons and the demons are busy with progressive people. You're busy blaming the demons and the demons are busy with progressive people. Hallelujah. Your problem is not spiritual. It's habitual. Hallelujah. It's not spiritual, people of God. It's habitual. You are struggling to progress because you fail to plan. Am I talking to somebody right now? You're struggling to progress because you fail to plan. Let me tell you a story. Hallelujah. Let me tell you a story, people of God. As a young person, career focused, as a young professional, I always had a plan. The best time of my life professionally It happened because I had a plan. I might not have said it to people, but I planned it. Everything that I did professionally was strategic. Nothing was sporadic. Everything that I did was strategic. None of it was sporadic. Hallelujah, Jesus. In 1998, I'm just sharing a little testimony with you now. In 1998, I won my first National Journalism Award. When I was writing those news stories that won me the award, let me tell you, I had the journalism awards in my mind. When I was writing my stories, I was writing stories of a certain quality because I had the awards in my mind. I had set my sights on it. I had set my sights on enhancing my career by winning one of those trophies. It was no accident. It was no accident. In 2008, when I won my second award, it was no accident either. It wasn't an accident. It was the first time in our journalism history in Jamaica that there was an award for online journalism. You know what I did? When I found out that an award was coming, a new award was coming for online journalism, I wanted to win that thing, you know. So you know what I did? I had a newsletter. I used to send out that newsletter to people in my industry, people in media, people in communications. I developed that newsletter and I was sending it out. When I heard about this new category that was coming on board for the National Journalism Awards, guess what I did, people of God? I turned the newsletter into a website. That's a plan. That's a strategy. Use your head. Use wisdom. Hallelujah, Jesus. When I heard that that award was coming on board, I turned that newsletter into a website, positioning myself to win. I tell you, everything I do in my career is strategy. Nothing is sporadic. Nothing is sporadic. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to God. I set my sights on winning that award by putting out high quality stories on a website. And guess what? My reward came in December 2008. I won the award, National Journalism Award for online journalism, first time in Jamaica, sponsored by Microsoft. That was like a few months after I had my last child. I still had the baby fat on me, but I dressed myself like a queen and I went to collect my award with my baby fat. Hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, people of God, when you want something, you must plan. When you want something, you must strategize. When you want something, you must ask God for wisdom. My God. Am I talking to somebody this morning? People of God, listen. Things happen, but not everything that happens in your life is a curse. Cycles will break off your life when you plan. Hallelujah. Share this live if you haven't shared it yet. Somebody needs to hear this. This word is wisdom this morning. Share this. If you have shared before, share it again. This is wisdom. Many people need to hear this word this morning. Come on, people of God, share it. Some things that are happening in your life has nothing to do with curses. They can be broken off your life if you have a plan. Some of us, we are struggling unnecessarily because we do not plan what we want. In life, you must have a plan. Something that guides the actions that you take and the things that you do. Hallelujah. There must be a goal, people of God. A goal that you are after. Something that you put before God and say, Lord, here is my plan. Order my steps. Remember, you know, the scripture tells you, man plans his way, but God order your steps. So when you make that plan, you go before God and you say, Lord, here is my plan. Order my steps. Hallelujah, Jesus. Somebody type, order my steps, Lord. Type it right now. Order my steps, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. People of God, listen. Sometimes there is no demon hampering you. We hamper ourselves because we fail to do the things that we should do. Stop wavering, people of God. Stop swirling in the wind. The wind blow east, you go with east. The wind blow west, you go west with it. You need to take control of the things that are preventing you from striving. Take control of those things. Hallelujah, Jesus. You can break that cycle of disappointment off your life if you develop a plan and have a strategy. If you are ready to break that cycle, just type it. I must have a plan. I must have a plan. Hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, people of God. This morning, I am moving you from a place of stagnation. This morning, I am moving you from a place of ignorance to a place of enlightenment. Hallelujah, Jesus. The cycles over your life, the cycles of disappointment must be broken. They must be broken off your life this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit, my God. The next thing that stops you sometimes, when you realize negative cycles and patterns, you keep going over the same thing happening in your life and you're not progressing. Sometimes it's because of the decisions that you make. Hallelujah. Come on now, people of God. It's the decisions that you make that causes you to have repeated cycles of disappointment in your life. The choices that you make. Listen, much of what happens to us in life is because we made a decision to do something, but the decision was not the best one for us, or it was not the best one at that time. We might even say we made a decision, a bad decision, but we didn't know what to do, because that happens, you know. You make a bad decision because you didn't really know what to do. Hallelujah. But listen to you. Listen to me. The Bible tells us that every action has a consequence. And if you don't know what decision to make, you need to ask God and He will guide you. If you don't know what decision to make, you need to ask God. He will guide you. Listen, people of God, James 1 and verse 5, it says, if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God that giveth to all men liberally and upbraideth not, and it shall be given to him. So God is saying to you, if you don't know what to do, come to me and I'll tell you. Come to me and I'll show you. James 1 verse 5. So if you're struggling to make good decisions, all you need to do is put it before God. Put it before God and you'll get your answers. You'll get your directives. Come with me now to Proverbs 2 and verse 6. Hallelujah. For the Lord gives wisdom from his mouth, come knowledge and understanding. Proverbs 2 and verse 6, it's in the scriptures. God is saying to you, all of you who is watching, if there are patterns of negativity in your life that are the results of bad situations, bad decisions, you need to come to him and he'll give you wisdom. Stop relying on your flesh. Stop relying on your flesh, people of God. You're heading for problems. We fail at things because we do not seek the face of God before we jump into the race. We do not seek God's face before we jump into the race. And that's why you got problems. You end up with the wrong people because we don't ask God, is this the right person for me? We make decisions according to our will and not according to God's will for our lives. So you're making the decision according to what you want and just you. You don't say, God, is this what you wanted for me? God, is this part of the blueprint that you have for my life? You take up a woman. You take up a man. You don't say, God, is this person part of my journey? Is this person is supposed to be my wife? Is this person supposed to be my husband? You're married. And then the things crash down later on down the line. It happened to me, so I know. I never knew God them time. I knew God existed. But I didn't have no time for God. I didn't have no relationship with God. You meet somebody, them sweep you off your feet. You have butterflies floating around all over you. You can't sleep at night because you keep hearing their voices. And you head over heels. So you run and go married and you don't even say, God, is this the right person? You cannot walk according to the flesh. You have to walk according to the spirit. These are the bad decisions that you make that keep repeating cycles of negativity in your life. Those cycles need to be broken off your life by making better decisions. If you don't know what to do, if you don't know what to say, go to God and say, guide me. God, tell me what to do. So we make bad choices, people of God. When you don't consult with God, we make bad choices which lead to disappointment. We make bad choices which lead to hurt. We make bad choices which lead to a cycle of failure in our lives. There's a saying that you cannot keep doing the same thing over and over and expect a different result. Hallelujah. But many times, people of God, we are caught up in our ways. We are so set in our ways. It's like some old people. You know, old people are people after a certain age, you can't change anything for them. They are set in their ways. Some of us, that's how we are. We are so set in our ways that we keep doing the same thing over and over. And we cry when we get the same disappointing results. Our minds are not renewed. So our outcomes do not change. Hallelujah, Jesus. If your mind is not renewed, your outcome will not change. Listen, for years I kept choosing the wrong kinds of men because I didn't ask God anything. I didn't say to God, is this the right person for me? I thought they were right. I thought that this person was right for me because they needed me, not because they enhanced me. I thought they were right for me because they needed me, not because they enhanced my life. They needed somebody who could pour into them and help them overcome something they were struggling with. But in the process, I forgot that I wasn't Jesus Christ. I was not Jesus Christ, people of God. I couldn't fix them. Only God could do that. So the relationships failed, and I was right back to square one until the next needy person came along. So it was a cycle that kept repeating itself. I kept going back to square one. I was struggling with disappointment in my relationships because the choices that I was making was causing the disappointment. I was choosing the same kind of people each time, and I was making those choices without God. So many of you watching me right now, you're in the same cycle that I'm speaking about, and you need God to get out. You're in the same cycle that I was in, and you need God to get out. God is calling you today to renew your mind so that your results will change. Make better decisions, people of God. Make better choices. And watch the cycle of disappointment. Watch the cycle of negativity leave your life. When you make better decisions, the cycle will be broken. So here we go. Some of us, you experience cycles of disappointment because of bad decisions. But on the other hand, some of us, we struggle because we don't take any decisions at all. So our outcomes are the same because we fail to take action. We fail to decide. So you can decide and you make wrong decision. And on the other hand, you're indecisive. So things do not change because you don't make a decision. Your outcomes remain negative because of your indecisiveness. Hallelujah. People of God, sometimes we make a decision and then we flip-flop. We flip-flop and we change our minds. So things do not become established. Things do not get a chance to grow. The seeds do not get a chance to germinate because you plant it today and you pull it out tomorrow. The Bible says that a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. When you are unstable, things will manifest in your life because there are no roots. Are you hearing me, somebody? When you are unstable, good things will not manifest in your life. Because there are no roots. You don't have any roots. There is no grounding. Jesus. To break that cycle of disappointment off your life, you have to start making some firm decisions, people of God. You have to make decisions about the elephant in the room. You have to start making decisions about the mountain in your life. Some of you, you have some decisions, but you are hesitating. You have some important decisions to make, but you're hesitating. Last week, the Lord gave me a word, and I believe I released it on Facebook. I released that word in a post. The Lord gave me a word last week that some of you have some important decisions to make, but you are hesitating to make the decisions because you're afraid. Hallelujah. You don't want to go ahead because you're afraid. Make the decisions, says the Spirit of the Living God. Make the decisions. I have assigned angels to encamp about you. That is a word I released on my page for you earlier in the week. The Lord said, make the decision. I have sent angels to encamp about you. Stop hesitating out of fear, people of God. Stop hesitating out of fear. God has not given you a spirit of fear. He has given you a spirit of love, power, and a sound mind. You need to use that love, use that power, use that sound mind to make decisions that will break the cycle of negativity off your life. Hallelujah. Are you hearing me, somebody? God has not given you a spirit of fear. Do not hesitate to make the decision because you are fearful. Use that sound mind that God has given you. Use that power. Use it to make decisions that will break the cycle of negativity off your life. Jesus. Come on, somebody, type, I will make good decisions. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I will make good decisions. My God, my God. Come on, people of God, it's time to break those cycles off your life. I know some of you came on this live expecting me to minister to you about generational curses only. But I have to be honest with you. I have to move as the Spirit leads me. Not everything in your life that is not going right has anything to do with generational curses. A lot of things happen sometimes because you make bad decisions. It's your choices. A lot of things happen sometimes because you are indecisive. You refuse to make a decision. Hallelujah, Jesus. So it's not just generational curses. It's not just bloodline curses. Right now I know some of you are exhausted. Some of you are exhausted. You're tired. You are fed up. You are frustrated because nothing is going the way you planned. Every time you take a step forward, you get thrown two steps backward. Hallelujah, Jesus. Every time things look like they're about to change, the same disappointing news comes to you. Hallelujah. It's like a cycle of bad news. A cycle of failure in your life. In Jamaica, we would say, nothing nah, gwan for you. Hallelujah. In Jamaica, we would say, you're bad luck, it are your salt. My God. I would say, bad luck, I follow you. My God. Listen. Some of you are going through some cycles. It's not pretty. Cycles of disappointment. Some of you, you go to a job interview. Several job interviews. You do your interview and you feel like, yes, you did well. And still nobody calls you and give you the job. You take that one examination over and over and you can't pass it. You go to the embassy over and over and you still cannot get a visa to travel. Hallelujah. You have been working hard all your life. Over and over, you work like a horse and you still cannot qualify for a mortgage. You treat the people who come into your life so good, hallelujah, Jesus, and they still get up and leave you. Am I talking to somebody this morning? It's like you're caught in a cycle of disappointment and you can't understand why. Oh God. Sometimes, people of God, listen keenly. Sometimes the reason you are facing repeated cycles of disappointment, the reason why you have repeated cycles of hurt and pain, is because of a family curse. Sometimes these setbacks in your life are the result of a bloodline or a generational curse. Sometimes it's not anything you have done wrong. It's not anything you have done wrong. It's a bloodline curse. Things that have been passed down in your bloodline for generations. But you don't know it. You are there and you don't know it. So you are fighting, but you are not winning. You are fighting, but you are not winning. Here's why. You are fighting and not winning because you're fighting with the wrong tools. You're fighting with the wrong strategy. Hallelujah. You are fighting spiritual warfare with physical weapons. You ain't gonna get nowhere. It doesn't work like that, people of God. The truth is that you cannot fight an enemy that you don't know. You have to study the enemy. You have to know the enemy's weakness so you can develop a strategy to beat that enemy. Hallelujah. So when people are struggling with issues that are related to something in their bloodline, they cannot fix it properly if they don't understand what is behind it. And I'm not talking to you about fairy tales right now. I'm speaking truth, people of God. Listen, the scripture tells you clearly that the sins of our forefathers, our great-grandfather, your great-great-great-grandfather, their sins affect you. It says the punishment for the parents' sin fall into the laps of their children after them. It's all there in the word of God. So let's go deeper. I'm not guessing anything. I'm not telling you a fairy tale right now. Turn your Bibles to Jeremiah 32 and verse 18. Jeremiah 32 and verse 18. Let me read for you. It says, and I'm reading from the New International Version. It says, you show love to thousands, but bring punishment for the parents' sin into the laps of their children after them. So the scripture tell you. It says you bring punishment for the sins of your forefathers into your laps. The sins of your forefathers fall into your laps, the generations that come behind. So sometimes you are wondering, why is it that so many people in your family end up divorced? Why is it that so many people in one family have mental issues? Why is it that so many people in one family suffer from depression? Why is it that so many people in one family have countless children with multiple women? The men, for example, have a whole heap of children with different women, and they never get married. Why is it that the women in your family rarely get married? Why is it that the men in your family have a gambling problem or a drinking problem or a drug problem? Why is it that your grandfather had a drinking problem and now your son or your nephew is struggling with the same thing? These are the questions you ask sometime. Why is it that everybody in your family struggle through life and not one person is better able to lift themselves up financially? Why is it, listen to me now, women, why is it that so many women in your family end up with married men who never marry them? Are you hearing me, somebody? Why is it that so many women in your family end up with married men who never marry them? They get old waiting on these men. They get old waiting because they're there waiting. The man say, I'm going to marry you, and it never happens. Auntie do it, granny do it, cousin do it, daughter do it. It's a generational curse. I could pinpoint so many more examples for you this morning of cycles in families. Cycles that come right down to you and in your family, and you don't understand why you're having these troubles with your kids. Today I want to open your eyes, people of God, how to get out of cycles in your life that could be a result of bloodline curses. Let me tell you something. When I was growing up in our little community, everybody knew everybody. But there were certain patterns within certain families that we noticed in the community. Even as children, we noticed it. We noticed that there were some families that had men who were natural thieves. Are you hearing me? Let me turn on the music to make sure you hear me. We noticed that some families had men who were natural thieves. It might sound harsh, but it is true. Some of these men in particular, they're just thief. They like to steal. They were always getting locked up. They get locked up for break shop. People in Jamaica know what I'm talking about. The little shop there on the corner. And they broke the shop and take out the little drinks them and whatever in there. So you have men in families who all of them just thief. They always a broke shop and end up in jail. Them always a thief cow and get locked up. Them always a thief goat and get locked up. Them always a thief pig and get locked up. Because they had a little teeth in nature. People would say you have a teeth in nature, and you. It's a bloodline curse. It's a bloodline curse. They can't help themselves. It's a generational curse that is coming down. Why all of them teeth? It needs to be broken off their lives. And you have some who love to rape. No matter what. Nice boy, them, you know, look good and everything, and they mess up their life because they love rape. They're always getting locked up for rape. It's like they were under the influence of something that caused them to behave in this way. Because it's a spiritual problem, but most times we don't know these things because a lot of churches don't teach these things. They don't teach you about generational curses. They don't teach you about deliverance. So the people go through life and nothing changes. The whole of the boy, them get locked up because they're my teeth. All of them come with a drinking problem. All of them come with a gambling problem. And they don't get any help. They struggle through life. Nothing changes until they die. Because nobody recognizes a generational curse. Nobody has suggested deliverance. People of God, when the reason for your struggle is a bloodline curse, there's a spiritual problem. You can't fight that in the natural. Your warfare is against principalities and powers, rulers of the darkness, spiritual wickedness in high places. That's where your warfare is. It's not against the neighbor. People of God, Ephesians 6:12, let me remind you. It says, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. That is the battle you are facing, many of you, but you don't recognize it. So you cannot fight the war. You are not doing the things that you are supposed to do. You are not using the right tactics. You are not using the right tools because you are fighting an enemy that you don't even know exists. You are fighting an enemy that you don't understand how to fight him. Hallelujah, Jesus. You are not properly armored for the battle that you are going into. So you lose the the fight. The victory cannot come. The cycle keeps repeating. The negativity keeps happening because the curse is not broken. It's not broken because you're fighting with the wrong tools. It's not broken because you have the wrong strategy. It's not broken because you are living in ignorance. You don't know these things. So you don't defeat the problem. You won't defeat the problem. You won't break the cycle by complaining and cursing. You won't break it by going to the Obia man or the witch doctor. You have to put on the full armor of God. You have to put on the full armor of God. Listen now, people of God, very keenly. Breaking negative cycles over your life that are spiritual begins with repentance. Come on, somebody, type repentance. Repentance, hallelujah. Breaking negative cycles that are generational curses, it begins with repentance. Type it, people of God. Repentance. Just type it right now. Hallelujah. Repentance must come first. You got to clean up your life. Get rid of the things and the behaviors that are not pleasing in the sight of God. You must repent on behalf of your generations and receive salvation. Hallelujah. It will not break until you repent. And you repent on behalf of your generations. Repent on behalf of your family. Some of you need to intercede for your family. Hallelujah, Jesus. Some of them are not spiritual. You might have some knowledge and they don't. So God has chosen you. Many of you who are watching me right now, you are carrying the breaker anointing for your generations and you don't even know it. You are carrying the breaker anointing for your family and you don't know it. God has selected you to break some things off your family. That is why your battles have been more intense than your sisters and your brothers in your family. That is why you have faced so many struggles. That is why your warfare is greater, because you are carrying the breaker anointing for your family. So your struggles are greater. Your warfare is greater. Your battle is hotter. You're not a black sheep. God has selected you to be the deliverer for your bloodline. It's not that you're a black sheep. Why you have more problems and challenges than your brothers and your sisters? It's because you have been selected. You are carrying a breaker anointing. You're a deliverer for your bloodline. So when you repent on behalf of your generations, when you renounce those covenants that your great grandparents made, when you tear down those altars with the blood of Jesus Christ, you release blessings over yourself and over your family, over your generations to come. Because the biblical principle is that what you sow is what you reap. So you repent on behalf of your family. You intercede for your family. You go into fasting for your family to break some things off your bloodline. And when the blessings are released upon you, it goes down to your generations. You reap what you sow. Hallelujah. Am I talking to somebody this morning? So those of you who are struggling with generational curses, you can't get no work no matter how you try. You're always sick. All kind of sickness. Cancer run in your family. Lupus run in your family. Asthma run in your family. You can't have a good relationship. Everybody come into your life, they just take from you and go and leave you. No matter how you try, you can't get married. No matter what, only married men keep coming into your life. All of these things are bloodline curses. Bloodline curses that need to be broken off your life. And I am telling you this morning the strategy. So the strategy, people of God, is repentance first and foremost. You repent. And you repent for yourself, repent for your generations. Some of us, we have great grandparents who used to do evil things and we don't even know it. They have raised up altars that are affecting you right now. There was something they wanted, but they raised an altar to get that thing. And you were part of that sacrifice. They gave you in exchange for riches. They gave you in exchange for wealth. An altar was lifted up before you were even born, some of you. And it's affecting you in your life right now. And you don't know. So these are things. When you're repenting, you must repent for your bloodline. Repent for your forefathers and the sins of your forefathers. Ask the Lord to tear down those altars. Send the fire of the Holy Spirit to burn up those altars that were lifted up that are affecting you. These are the kind of prayers that you pray. You repent and then you go into intercessory prayer for your family. Your warfare is not natural. It's not against flesh and blood. You're not wrestling against flesh and blood, many of you. It's against principalities and powers that you don't even know how to fight. So I implore you this morning, now that I have given you this message, now that I have enlightened you, to seek the face of God. Seek the face of God to break those generational curses. Seek the face of God to cancel those curses off your life and off your children's lives. You see, because I have knowledge, the scripture says the lack of knowledge, my people perish because of the lack of knowledge. So because I now have the knowledge, I know how to fight these things. Previously, I didn't know. So for years, I struggled. I struggled with some things and kept wondering, how come I'm so nice to people? And I buck up so many terrible people in my life who treat me like crap. And I'm so nice to them. How come I'm such a giver, always giving things to people, and nobody not giving anything to me? These are things that I struggled with. And I didn't understand that it had nothing to do with me. It had nothing to do with me. It was a bloodline curse. I pray this morning that you have been enlightened. I pray that God has opened your eyes to understand why is it that there are certain things that are happening in your life and you can't seem to get past them. I'm going to go through for you, just to wrap up for you, the three things that I touched on today. Three reasons why you have negative patterns, negative cycles happening in your life. I told you lack of vision. When you don't have a vision, when you don't have a plan, when you don't have a strategy, you go around in circles because nothing is organized and God is a God of order. And he tells you in the scriptures that you must write the vision and make it plain. So as of today, you need to start writing that vision if you haven't done so. You need to write that vision. You must have a plan. You must have a strategy. Some things that are affecting you has nothing to do with demons. It's a lack of planning. It's a lack of focus. It's a lack of discipline. It's a lack of strategy. Hallelujah. And you need to break those things off your life by writing the vision, as the Holy Spirit said. Write the vision and make it plain so that it can be executed. The next thing is the decisions that you make. I'm just wrapping up for you. You make bad decisions. Every action has a consequence. So when you make the bad decision, certain things keep happening in your life. And until your mind is renewed, until you change your approach, things will not change. So it's your decision making. And you need to go to God and ask him for guidance, ask him for wisdom to make good decisions. And you struggle too because of indecision sometimes. Some of you don't want to make decisions because you're afraid. You're afraid of what people will say. You're afraid of what people will do. You're just afraid of displeasing people. Some of you are people pleasers. You are looking for approval from people. So you don't want to make certain decisions because you don't want to upset people. I used to be like that in my younger days. I wanted everybody to be happy. And guess what? In trying to make everybody happy with my decisions, I ended up unhappy. So that is what is happening to a lot of you right now. You try so hard to make other people happy that you end up unhappy. So it's your decisions that are affecting you and causing the repeated negative cycles in your life. The third one are the bloodline curses. The things that are coming down in your family line. The things that are coming down from your great-great-great-great-great-grandparents. Some of them raised up altars that are affecting you now. Some of them got into evil covenants that you are paying the price for it now and can't break out of it because you don't know. So those curses need to be broken off your life through repentance and salvation. Repent. Get covered. Get saved. Get covered under the blood. Intercede for your family. Go into fasting to break these things off your life. Another thing that can affect you too are curses that you yourself have spoken. You open your mouth sometimes and do not realize the implications of what you say. So sometimes it's the words you have released over your life. Father God, I'm tired of this. I'm not going to come to nothing. Lord have mercy. I soon go to prison. Because you owe some money, you start talking things like, I soon go to prison. I soon end up in prison. Those are curses that you're speaking over your life. And these curses need to be broken. They are self-inflicted curses. Hallelujah. So you speak self-inflicted curses over your life. And then you have repeated cycles of negativity happening to you. And you don't know that it's your mouth that condemned you. You don't know that it's the words that you spoke. So you are suffering sometimes from self-inflicted curses, words that you have spoken over your life, which you should not have spoken. And sometimes it's words that others have spoken over you. Sometimes you have a neighbor. The neighbor look and see the car in your driveway. The neighbor look and see you doing some work on your house. You change the windows, you change the doors. And they begin to speak curses against you because they are jealous, they are envious. So they begin to release curse words. They look through their window. They come on their veranda. They come to their fence and they release curse words. The Bible tells you that the heart of man is inherently wicked. People are like that. They don't want to see each other prosper. So sometimes there are self-inflicted curses, and there are curses that people speak over your life, and there are generational curses. So all of these things, the negative patterns and cycles, and the sickness that you experience sometimes, if you notice that so many people in your family dying from one disease, you need to begin interceding for your family for that curse to be broken. You decree and declare that it stops with you. It stops now. I am a bloodline breaker in the mighty name of Jesus. I curse cancer. I decree and declare that the infirmity of cancer over my family is broken as of now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I cover my children and my children's children under the blood. I take authority over this disease now in the mighty name of Jesus. And I decree and declare that as of today, no more cancer will be in my family. This is how you should begin to speak. Intercede for your family. Decree and declare over your life. And intercede for those who will come after you. Ascend the fire of the Holy Spirit right now to locate and destroy every altar that has been lifted up against my family in the mighty name of Jesus. Every bloodline curse from my mother's side, every bloodline curse from my father's side, I cancel it now in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree and declare that the sins of my forefathers will not reach me or my children in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. These are how you speak out against curses. You repent and you begin to intercede. Some things that look so simple to you, people of God, is not as simple as they look. They're not as simple as they look. There's something far deeper going on. I was on Facebook the other day, and I saw a family. Somebody posted a video of this family. And the lady was walking with her hands on the floor. She was walking like an animal. And I took one look at that woman, and the Holy Spirit said to me, bloodline curse. Jesus. Some people were there saying it's a back problem that she had, and that is why she bent over and walking like that. There was somebody else in the bed who was inflicted with a spirit of infirmity, and other members of the family. Anybody with a spiritual eye, as soon as you look, you will realize that's a spiritual problem. It's not something in the natural. The woman is walking on her hands like an animal. That's a bloodline curse. Somebody needs to just intercede for that family. I want you to begin to intercede for your family. As of today, break every negative pattern in your life. Every bloodline curse in your life must be broken. Begin to intercede for your family in the name of Jesus. Begin to speak, cancel curses, and release blessings. See blessings over your family. In the same way that you have generational curses, do you know that you have generational blessings? It's just like the blessing of Abraham. And it's just like when God told Joshua, he will bless him and make his name great. You have generational blessings too. It is time for you to take authority over those things which have kept you back. Take authority over those things which have kept you in a cycle of poverty, a cycle of sickness, a cycle of disappointment. All of those things which have held you back. and are affecting your children and your children's children, you need to take authority. Begin to intercede. Cancel them. God has given you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions. Many of you not using it. Hallelujah. I remember I was going through some serious issues around 2014, in the same time when I had the whole heap of court matters. And I was complaining because I didn't know how to fight certain things. And I think two or three men of God I spoke to, and the three of them gave me the same word. The first word that came out of their mouth was authority. The Holy Spirit says, you're not taking authority. People of God, it hit me like a ton of bricks. Because I'm like, oh my God, all I need to do is start speaking the word over my life. Begin to pray and fast. I was not taking authority over them. I allowed the thing to look bigger than my God. And that's what many of you are doing. You're allowing the thing to look bigger than your God. What is before you cannot compare to the God that is behind you. Your thing that is facing you cannot be bigger than the God that is behind you. So you need to take authority. The scripture tells you, Jesus himself said that we will do even greater things than he did. But some of you, you don't believe that you can. You don't believe you have authority. You don't believe that you have power. Let me tell you something. Whenever I'm ministering, and that is why I take no credit. When people come to me with testimonies of healing and breakthrough, I take no credit. Me, by myself, I'm just a conduit. I'm just a messenger. I'm just a channel God is using. And he's using me because I was called and because I made myself available. Because there are many of you who God has called, but you have not made yourself available, so he's not using you. You are called, but you have not made yourself available. So I'm saying to you, you can take authority over a lot of things that are happening in your life and in your family. You can break that spirit off your back. You can cancel that spirit of disappointment. You can cancel that spirit of depression. If only you begin to take authority. Use the power that God has given you. Many times I pray for people, and some people I told you I don't pray for. I just speak the word over their lives. And guess what? When I speak the word, I speak it with authority. And when I release that word with authority, it becomes established in the realms of the spirit. When I release that word, I release it with faith. I release it with expectation. So God moves. Have you noticed, for some of you who follow the ministry, that sometimes I'll speak over somebody's life and by the following day they get breakthrough? Because I'm taking authority. I'm taking authority. Some of you, like those of you who the bank is about to take your car, or the bank want to take your house, your mortgage company want to take your house because you're in arrears, you need to put your hand on your car, put your hand on your house and begin to decree and declare that my house shall remain mine in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. No plan of the enemy against my ownership of this house shall prevail. Things like those, begin to decree and declare, put your hand on the car, put your hand on the house, walk through your house with the olive oil, anoint up your windows, anoint up your doors, decree and declare your ownership. Take authority over the house, is your own, it shall not depart from you. I have a testimony, I can't even share it in detail with you. It is so powerful, I can't even share it in detail, because some of you won't even understand. Some of you won't understand. I'll just speak in parables and say to you that there was something I wanted. I wasn't the only person who wanted it. I was in line to get it, but somebody was ahead of me to get it. And they were in a better position to get it than I was. They basically had it in their hands. And I just began to pray. For 3 days, I just began to pray and to decree and declare over the situation. And I said, Father God, let them cancel. I said, God, let them cancel. I got a call advising me 2 days ago that the people canceled. I spoke the words out of my mouth. I took authority. I said, God, do what you need to do. But I want that. I said, settle it for me. I said, it is mine. Settle it for me. I want that. And it's not anything to hurt anybody, so don't get me wrong. It's just something where I was in line to get it, but others were ahead of me. So I asked the Lord to release favor over my application. I said, Lord, release favor over my application. I said, it is mine. I said, do what you need to do. It is settled. I took authority. Don't ask me why the people cancel. Don't ask me how them cancel. I prayed and I said, God, let them cancel. 2 days ago, I get the call. They cancel. So I get it. These are the principles I want to teach you to take authority over those things which are controlling your life. Do what you must do in the natural and hand over the rest to God. Don't just say, I cancel this and I cancel that. You need to do something to cancel it. Do it too. Put some things in order. Position yourself to get what you desire. Position yourself for that breakthrough. Position yourself for that cycle to be broken off your life and off your children's lives. Position yourself to get that job you desire. Position yourself to get that house. Position yourself to come out of that cycle of poverty. Position yourself to come out of the cycle of debt. Position yourself to collect the things that God has for you. Because he told you he has them. He said it in Jeremiah 29:11. So what are you waiting for? Claim them up. Position yourself to receive them. Cancel the curses and begin to release generational blessings over your life. Power, 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 power. Faith, authority. Power, power, power. There is power in the blood, people of God. There is power in the blood. Hallelujah, 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 Jesus. There is power in the blood. You know what happened the other day? I was praying for someone. They put me on speaker and I was praying for them. Somebody was passing by and heard me praying for the person. And you know what the person did? They just began to receive. It's not for them, you know? It's past they're passing by and heard me praying for somebody on the phone. They heard me on speaker and I was praying for the person and they began to receive. It's not theirs, you know? But they came into agreement and began to receive and get breakthrough for themselves. I wasn't praying for them. They were passing unheard and they just received by faith and get breakthrough. Come on, people of God. There is power in the blood and power in your mouth. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. I see somebody asking a question. They were saying something. Oh, on your answer, did you consider the other person could be a person of God? Listen, God works in mysterious ways. If they were a person of God, then maybe they didn't need it as much as I did, George. So God let them release it to me. So that's your answer. So maybe if they were people of God, the Lord can speak into their spirit. The Holy Spirit can speak into their spirit. And they release it because they didn't need it as much as I did. So God works in mysterious ways. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. All right, people of God. So that is the word that I have to share with you today. And I hope that you have been blessed. If you have been blessed, just let me know. I've been blessed. Let me know that you have been blessed. If you have been blessed, let me know. Hallelujah. I'm looking for a song for you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I'm going to play that song for you right now. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. All right, I'm pulling up a song for you. Thank you, Jesus. Let it be done for your people this morning, God. Let it be done for them in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Break every bloodline curse from off your lives. This is your song. Some of you who have been buried, you are being resurrected. So this is your song. Every bloodline curse must be broken off your life today. This is your song. Yes, my sister Stacy. Power, power, power. This is your song. Is registered in heaven. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
I have resurrection power. Still the miracle that I just can't get over.
People, let nobody tell you anything. The journey here might be hard, but life in Christ is sweet. Nothing compares to when you see God moving in your life. Nothing compares to when you see miracles manifesting. Nothing compares to when you see breakthrough happening. Nothing compares to when you speak a word and see that God has moved on your behalf. So let nobody tell you any foolishness. God is real. I am living testimony that God is real. Hallelujah. Living testimony. God is real. This is your song. Just worship right now and give him thanks. Give him thanks for everything that is breaking off your life today. Every negative cycle, cycles of poverty, cycles of disappointment in relationships, every anti-marriage spirit is being broken off your life. We come against it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree and declare over every woman on this live, if you have been having relationships with men who are already taken, I break that curse off your family. I break it off your life right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I decree and declare that every imposter that is coming at you, the Lord will expose them and he will block them. I'm asking God right now to put a hedge of protection and a fencing around you in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree and declare that every deceiver who is seeking to come in your life, they shall be exposed right now. Everything that is coming against you and coming against your blessing in marriage, let it scatter by fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I speak blessings over your life for financial increase in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare this is the last season that your hands shall be empty. This is the last season that your blessing shall be withheld. I speak release over you. Release over your blessings in the name of Jesus. Let everything that has been held up for you in the realms of the spirit be released now. Every money that you have, even money that you don't know about, I command it to come forth. I command it to be released now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I speak a blessing over the work of your hands. Let your hands be blessed. Hallelujah, Jesus. I'm going to anoint my hands and lift them up for you right now in the name of Jesus. And I know you're going to come back with testimonies. Hallelujah. I'm anointing my hand and I'm going to lift it on the screen for you right now. Lift up your hands in alignment with mine. Father, I decree and declare that every hand that is lifted up in alignment with your servants right now, Father, that blessing shall come upon them. Blessing shall come upon their household. Blessing shall come upon the work of their hands. I release favor right now, Father. Uncommon favor over the work of their hands in the mighty name of Jesus. Let everything that has been held up for them be released now. Mighty God, I speak release over their monies now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, I speak open doors. I speak increase over their lives in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah, Jesus. My God, I speak a generational blessing over their family right now. Mighty God, everything that has been held up for them, everything, my God, they have been fighting, every sickness in their family, I come against it now. I cancel those sicknesses now. I cancel asthma. I cancel cancer. I cancel diabetes. I cancel lupus. Everything in their bloodline that has been affecting them, I decree and declare a break anointing over them right now as they lift up their hands in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree and declare a break anointing over them right now in Jesus' name. Father God, let it happen for your people this morning. Let it be released for them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. No more delays. Every spirit of delay, every snail spirit that is upon their life, we cancel it now in the name of Jesus. My God, we send forth these blessings with divine speed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I decree and declare that they shall cry no more. Hallelujah, Jesus. I decree and declare healing over their minds, healing over their bodies now. Father, the house that they require, the car that they require, I speak release over it now in the name of Jesus Christ. Everything that was blocking them, we send the fire of the Holy Ghost to it right now in the name of Jesus. We shall burn it to ashes. Every evil altar that was lifted up against their families, we come against it now and we cancel it by the blood. In the mighty name of Jesus, I decree and declare what their foreparents did not have, they shall have it. What their foreparents did not inherit, they shall inherit it. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I speak blessings, abundant blessings over them, over their families right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, mighty God, I ask right now, for those who have been struggling to get out of their little communities for years, they cannot get a visa. I decree and declare that the visa shall come. As of now, it is being released in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. For those who have not been able to buy a house, I speak release over them right now in the name of Jesus Christ. That house will come. It will come. It will come. It will come. I speak it over the cars to God that they desire, that that car will come in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Those who have been struggling, my God, with addiction, those who have been struggling with gambling, those who have been struggling with drinking, I come against those spirit of addiction right now in the mighty name of Jesus, and we cancel them by the blood. Every person who is on this live who is struggling with a smoking issue, I come against that spirit right now. I decree and declare that you are being cleansed right now. Spirit of the living God, release angels to begin to flush and cleanse their bloodstream in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree and declare that that spirit must leave them today. That spirit is broken off their lives. All of the drunkards, the people who drink white rum day and night, I come against that spirit right now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. I decree and declare release over your people in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I decree and declare that gambling, it is over. I decree and declare the spirit of drinking, it is over. Alcoholism is broken off their life. It is broken off their bloodline now. I release the anointing, my God, for spiritual growth upon your people who are watching. As they lift your hands in agreement, my God, just begin to release the break anointing over them. Let them intercede for your family. Let breakthrough come for them now in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare no more stagnation, no more disappointment, no more rejection, no more depression in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Do it for your people this morning, God. Do it for them now as they come into agreement. Do it for them now in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let your will be done for your people this morning, God. Release it over them right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. What is the problem that you're having? I have a few more minutes with you. What is the problem that you're having in your family? What is the generational curse that has been hounding your family for years? Type it right now and let me speak against it. Hallelujah. Type it right now. Let me speak against it. Mighty God. Release, mighty God. Release over your people this morning in the name of Jesus. What is it that your family has been struggling with? Hallelujah. What is it that you need to break free from this morning? Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Come on, people of God. What is it that your family has been struggling with? Tell me quickly. Hallelujah. Tell me quickly so I can pray. Spirit of poverty. Hallelujah, Jesus. Let me see. Who is this? I'm trying to see who this is. Diabetes. Somebody said poverty. Somebody said diabetes. Audrey Williams is diabetes. Poverty. Perfectly made. Hallelujah. Poverty. Diabetes. Perfectly made, I speak against that spirit of poverty over your family in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I decree and declare whatever has been held up for you in the realms of the spirit, it shall be released. We cancel every curse over your family that has been preventing you from earning. We cancel every curse over your family that has kept you stagnant. I decree and declare that the blessings of Esau shall find you this morning. I release right now that the blessings of Jacob over your family in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree and declare that spirit of poverty is broken off you. You're a bloodline breaker. Connect with me right now. Connect with me right now for the break anointing over your family in the mighty name of Jesus. I come against that spirit of diabetes over your family. Who is that, Audrey? Hallelujah, Jesus. I decree and declare that healing is coming to your household. I decree and declare that the anointing for breakthrough is upon your family. You shall be healed from this disease in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that it stops with you. Everything that affected your parents and your foreparents, it stops with you. Your children are released now in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, Jesus. I speak release over you right now in Jesus' name. Jacqueline McFarlane said failed relationships and marriage. And Stacy Patty, the same thing for you. Hallelujah. Sweetie, all of you ladies who are having having a problem with relationships and marriage. I've been through it, so I can tell you it is real. I have been through it, so I can understand exactly what you're going through. And that is why the Lord has released me to do what I am doing. Hallelujah. Because I have a story to tell. My story is for His glory. And my story will prove to you that God can make things right with that situation. Hallelujah. I come against that anti-marriage spirit over your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, all of you women who are struggling with marriage and struggling with relationships, I come against that anti-marriage spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. Let me turn this music down because I got something I need to tell you. Some of you ladies who are struggling to get married, you are struggling with marine spirits. Are you hearing me? You are struggling with marine spirits. Some of you, you have spirit husbands. And that is what is preventing you from getting married. There is a spirit over your life, a spirit husband. Sometimes you get into relationships and everything look like it's gonna work out. Things are going okay and the man disappear. He don't call you back, or he just end the relationship without telling you why. Most of the times when you see that happening, it's a marine spirit. You have a spirit husband that is affecting you and preventing you from getting married. That is something for which you need deliverance. Hallelujah, Jesus. So I want to enlighten you. A lot of you who are watching, who maybe experience those problems, you're experiencing relationship problems. Every relationship fail, and you're a nice person. I said to you, I've been there, I've done it, I've been through it, so I know. Every one of you who has been experiencing that over your life, lift your hands right now in the name of Jesus. Father, I speak a release over your daughters right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, right now we ask that you take authority over this anti-marriage spirit in their life. Everything that is preventing them from having good relationships, everything that is preventing them from getting married, we cancel it now by fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We step out of agreement, my God, with every evil covenant that may have been raised over their lives that is preventing them from getting married. My God, we send the fire of the Holy Ghost now to every spirit husband that is over their life, that is blocking their Boaz. We come against them now in the name of Jesus. Mighty God, we ask that you scatter them by fire right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Release your daughters into their season of blessing. Release them, my God, with the Ruth anointing. Release them, God, with the Esther anointing. Let the spirit of marriage come upon them in the mighty name of Jesus. Release their Boaz, every Ishmael that is standing in their way. Expose him now, Father, and scatter them by fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every Ishmael that is preventing them from getting married, expose them now, God, and scatter them by fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. This is for all of you ladies who are struggling to get married. All of you who are having a problem with relationships. Hallelujah. And some of you, I want you to understand something else. Hallelujah. Some of you, the reason why you are struggling with marine spirits that are affecting you and preventing you from getting married is because you were watching porn, pornography, anything that allows that kind of spirit to come into, to access to you. Anything that allows that spirit to have access to you. And one of the gateways for that kind of spirit to come upon you, marine spirits, is by watching porn. Hallelujah, Jesus. Because your eye gates and your ear gates are entry points for demonic forces. Your eye gates, the things that you watch, the things that you listen to, they are entry points for demonic forces. So some of you are struggling with marine forces, marine spirits, because you were watching porn. You used to watch porn. Are you still watching porn? So you have to cut it off. You have to get rid of it so that God can release you. Hallelujah. There can be no legal gateways that is giving the enemy access to you. So you need to repent. You need to start walking in righteousness, so that the gateways can be closed up and you can be released from marriage. Hallelujah, Jesus. So these are the things that you need to understand. You're fighting an unseen enemy. You're fighting enemies that you do not know exist. So I'm enlightening you this morning. To cut it out, cut it out, cut it out. These are gateways. These are gateways for the enemy to afflict you in the areas of marriage, because marine spirits are being released over your life. Hallelujah, Jesus. I'm going to share with you a quick testimony. Hallelujah. I won't give any names, but let me explain something to you. I was with someone, and the person was struggling with marine spirits, but they didn't understand. I understood it. I knew it. I could see it, but they could not, because they don't understand. They just know that they explain to me that they hear voices sometimes. They want to do something. They want to do the right thing, but they hear the voices telling them to do something else. And it's like they have no control. They couldn't control their actions because the voice telling them to do something other than what they want to do. So they were being affected by marine spirits. And I was around the person And I saw firsthand their behavior and realized they were affected by marine spirits. And then the Lord showed me in a vision. Listen to me now, people of God, very keenly. The Lord showed me the person in a vision. And the person was driving a sports car. But guess what? The person was driving the car, but they were not the one controlling the steering wheel. He sat at what should be where the steering wheel is. That's where he was sitting in the sports car. But he was not the one driving. He sat there like he was driving. But the Lord showed me a woman sitting on top of his car. A beautiful, light-skinned woman sitting on top of his car. And she had a box in her lap. The woman was sitting on top of his car and she had a box in her lap and she was taking things out of the box. And she was taking things out of the box and releasing them. And when I looked in the realms of the spirit to see exactly what was happening, the woman had the steering wheel. So the man is in the car, right where the steering should be, but he was not turning the steering. She was sitting on top of the car with a box in her lap and she was steering the car. Hallelujah, Jesus. Mighty God, some of you is the first time you're hearing these things. These are things of the spirit. Hallelujah, Jesus. These are things that God will reveal to you. That's a marine spirit over his life. So he's not in control of his actions. That is why he cheated the way he did. That is why he behaved the way he did. He can't stay faithful because there's a marine spirit over his life. He can't see it, but I saw it on top of his car, steering the car. So the car, in the realms of the spirit, when we talk about the vehicle that you drive, the car that you drive, it's your journey of life. So his life is not being controlled by him. A marine spirit is controlling his life, and it's sitting on top of the car. So it's on top of him. It's controlling him. He's at the wheel, or where the wheel should be, but the wheel is not in his hand. It's in the hand of that marine spirit that was sitting on top of his car and steering it. So she's controlling his life. And this is happening to a lot of men and a lot of women, and you don't know. So I want to open your eyes this morning so you can understand a lot of cycles, cycles that are happening in your life. You don't know why, but they are spiritual. They are the result of spiritual things that are happening. It's not natural. So you have to try and understand people sometimes when they behave a certain way. Don't judge them. Because their behavior sometimes has nothing to do with them in the flesh. It's spiritual. It's demonic activity and they don't know it. They can't see it. They don't know what is going on with them. But you, as a person of the spirit, God will reveal it to you. So you'll see it. So a lot of men we see running up and down out there. And they can't settle down and they can't be faithful. It's a generational curse, some of them. It's demonic forces. They watch a lot of porn, some of them. Some of them, it's coming down from their bloodline. They can't settle. The others, it's marine spirits because they watch a lot of porn or they were exposed to a lot of sexually related or sexually charged things in their life. Some of them were abused. Women too. So it's not that damn bad. You see some nice girls out there sometime and they sleep around. Or they've been through quite a number of men. Sometimes it's not because they want to do it. It's a curse. It's something spiritual that is affecting them and they don't know. Don't be too quick to judge. Pray for people. When you pray for people, you'll be surprised at what God will reveal to you. Don't be too quick to judge. Don't curse people so easily. Pray for them. Pray for their release. Pray for God to show you what is happening to them in the realms of the spirit. And then when you see, begin to intercede for them. Yes, George, open our eyes to the attacks of the spirit. Hallelujah. So I just came here this morning at the leading of the spirit to enlighten you. And I pray that you have received this word that I've shared with you and that this word will transform your life. Not just spiritually, but physically. For those of you who don't have a plan and a vision, that's a physical thing. Go ahead and make your plan. Make your vision and make your plan. Put in place your strategy. Put in place structure and order in your life and see how things will change. For those of you who make bad decisions, start lifting up your decisions before God and he will give you answers. For those who are indecisive, don't be double-minded. Pray about it. And God will help you to overcome. And for those of you who are struggling with curses, it is time for you to begin to repent, get covered under the blood, get saved, and begin to intercede for yourself and for your family, for your generations to come. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Let me see, who is that? My sister about sleeping around and praying for them. Yes, my dear George, it is. Don't judge people so easily. Some of them, they can't control themselves because they don't understand what is going on. And a lot of times when you see women like this and they sleep around, is it coming from their bloodline? Just check out auntie. Check out grandma and grandaunt. Check out cousin. It's a family thing. Yep. Hallelujah. All right, let me see who I can pray for before I go. I just want to cover you all. Good morning to you, Dion Winter. Counsel, how are you doing? Kimmy Miller is saying, deliverance for my son. I need you. What wrong with your son, my darling? Inbox me afterwards, Kimmy. I feel your spirit. I feel so much tears in your spirit. Hallelujah. Inbox me afterwards so I can pray for your son. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, Jesus. Let me see, who is it that I can pray for before I get off the live? Bless the Lord. Good morning to you, counsel. Good morning. Marine spirit. Yes, people of God, all of you who are struggling with marine spirits, I pray that God will release you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. But you have to do something for yourselves too. God not gonna just release you if you don't stop watching the porn movies that you're watching. You have to stop watching them. You have to close your eye gates. Understand? You have to sanitize your atmosphere, because the Holy Spirit can't come in a place that is not clean. Excuse my expression, I'm speaking Jamaican language now. If the place is not clean, if the temple not clean, the Holy Spirit can't come in there and can't reside in there. So you have to clean up your temple. Hallelujah, Jesus. You have to clean up your temple. All right, Karine is saying she has pain on her left side. Let me pray for you, all of you who are having pain or any sickness. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands right now. The persons with pain. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, in the name of Jesus, I speak. I speak healing over your daughters and your sons who are on this live. Good morning, Andrea Dawkins. I speak healing over them by the blood of Jesus. You said that by your stripes we are healed, God. So this morning I release the break anointing for healing over your children who are watching. Every pain in their body, I command it to flee by the power of the blood of Jesus Christ. Every pain in their hand, pain in their legs, pain in their back, pain in their head, pain in their stomach, wherever that pain is right now, I connect in the name of Jesus, and I speak with the authority of a servant of God. I command that pain to flee from your body right now, to release you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I speak healing over you right now, from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Use your olive oil right now as I speak on the area of your body where you're having the pain. I command that pain to flee now by the power of the blood of Jesus Christ. Right now, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whatever illness you're experiencing, Father, we ask that you release angels to begin to purge. We ask that you release angels to begin to cleanse and to flush their system in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we decree and declare healing for them right now. Anything that is affecting them and affecting their families, we come against it by the power of the blood of Jesus. Let the blood begin to speak over them for healing right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Wherever you are, just begin to release anything on your heart that is not of God so you can receive your healing. All of you who are struggling with unforgiveness, before you receive healing this morning, you need to release some things. Those of you watching, you're struggling with unforgiveness, you're struggling with hatred and bitterness in your heart, and you're asking God to heal you. God Almighty wants you to release it and receive your healing. You need to forgive. You need to get past some things. Release them and ask the Lord to just forgive you. Father, forgive me for all the wrong I may have done to my neighbor. Father, forgive me for hating my neighbor. Father, forgive me for showing hatred towards the people in my family. Just ask the Lord to forgive you and repent so that you can receive your healing and receive your blessing. I'm telling you the truth. If your heart is dark, if you're bad mind, if you're envious, if you're wicked, don't bother come on this live and believe that God is just going to release things to you. You have to repent. Ask for forgiveness. It's not a candy shop. There is something that God wants from you. He wants you to repent. Repent so that these blessings can be released. If you know, say you went by somebody's house and you leave things over there in bottles, if you know you sprinkle powder at your neighbor, please ask for forgiveness right now for your healing. There's no healing until you forgive. You have to repent. Repent. The truth of the matter is, some people might not like me because I tell you the truth. And I have to tell you the truth because I cannot come here to deceive you and let you feel that the life that you live is okay. And God is still going to bless you and you're still going to go to heaven. It no works out. There are things you must do. There are things you must change. God loves you. He's a merciful, kind, and gracious God. I can tell you that with conviction because I've seen it in my own life. Through my own imperfections, before I became ordained. I was ordained in 2018, so I'm on my what? Second year as a pastor. Before I was ordained, I was walking righteously since what? 2016? Yes. Since 2016, I have been walking righteously and living a clean life. So God was not going to ordain me until I clean up my life. I had to clean up my life first. And when I say clean up my life, it's not that I was living a dirty life. But at the time, I said to you that I had one foot in the church. I was still there, going to church, being involved in ministry, spending my time with God, doing what God was saying I should do. Except for one thing. I had one foot in and one foot out in terms of a relationship. And that couldn't work with God. It couldn't work. Something had to give. So I gave up the relationship and decided, here what now? I'm going to walk with God straight. He will give me everything else that I desire. You can't hold on to something that you know is taking you away from the path that God has for you and expect that you're going to come into your blessings. It don't work like that. You can't hold on to certain lifestyle and believe that you're still going to be blessed and walk into. Grace is there. There is grace over your life and mercy. But never you ever take the grace of God for granted. Don't ever take the grace of God. So if you're misbehaving for quite some time, there must be a cutoff point. Grace will run out for you. There must be a cutoff point. You cannot continue along that path and expect that all the good things that God told you about in Jeremiah 29:11 are going to manifest in your life. They will not manifest in your life, not like that. So at some point, you have to make up your mind that here, what? My two feet must go in. I can't continue to have one foot out and one in. So that's a decision I made in 2016. And step right in with my two feet. And from my step right in with my two feet, my life changed. Spiritually, my life changed. My eyes opened wider. My ears opened more. I could hear God. I would pray for people and things would happen. But then in 2018, when I was ordained and I received impartation from my bishop, my late bishop, because he walked in all five offices of the prophet. All five offices. Me and this cough. When I received impartation from my bishop, who walked in all five offices of the fivefold ministry, I went to another level. I had a visitation from God after that and went to another level where I just spoke the word and people would get healed. I spoke the word and people would get breakthrough. So I'm saying to you, if I did not make up my mind in 2016 that I'm going to walk righteously, that I'm going to clean up my life, that I'm going to put both feet in, I couldn't do what I'm doing for you today. Deani, I don't know what else to drink. I drink ginger, I drink garlic, I drink all of those things. But I'm saying to you, when I come to minister, this cough just comes on. I'm here quite fine. But as soon as I come and start minister, boom, there comes the cough. So this is not just a physical thing, my dear. This is an attack. Yes. So people of God, I just want to leave that with you. The cycles over your life can be broken, but there is something you must do as well. Repent. Be saved. Walk in righteousness. Intercede for your family. I'm not here to judge a soul. I know a lot of things don't happen. happen overnight. You might be in a relationship and you don't want to leave the person. So you don't commit fully to God because you don't want to leave the person. So I understand things don't happen overnight, but if you pray, you will be surprised at how God works these things out. If you pray, He works them out. I've seen it happen so many times. I have seen it happen so many times. Thank you, Beverly McKay. Thank you, my dear. Continue to pray me up against this cough. I tell you, garlic, ginger, peppermint, everything. But as soon as I start ministering, the cough. Anyway, the devil is a liar. I see you, Kimmy Miller. Please inbox me. Everybody, I pray that you have been blessed by the word this morning. If you have been blessed, just let me know. Let me know that you have been blessed by the word this morning. I continue to pray for you. All of you who were looking for prayer this morning, if I haven't prayed for you on the live, don't worry. I will pray for you. Thank you, Tara. Tara Dial. Thank you very much, Carol Clark. You said, pray for me and my son. Okay, my dear. Morgan, good to have you. First time I'm seeing you on the live, Morgan. How do you pronounce your surname? Is it Cube and Coop? I don't know. Please forgive me if I messed it up. Charlotte Mitchell, God bless you. Drink thyme tea, that's candy. Let me try that one, sister, because I haven't tried the thyme tea. I didn't try that one, so I'm going to see if that works. But I pray that you all have been blessed and that transformation will take place in your life. Before I go, I want to say something quickly. A few weeks ago, I shared my testimony on the live, and I want you to understand something. When God takes us through processing and He allows us to go to the valley, when He allows you to go on your face right down to the bottom of the mountain, when He takes you from the top of the mountain and puts you at the foot of the mountain, and then He slowly lifts you up, when He allows you to go through all the things that you go through, that is your testimony. That is training. And it's your testimony. It's your story that will be for God's glory. All right? So when I come on alive and I give you a testimony, that was my life then. A testimony exists so that other persons can understand what is possible for them, what God can do for them, what God has done for others, so they will be inspired to know that He will do it for them as well. So that is why I come on and I'll give you a testimony. So when I came on and gave a testimony a few weeks ago, I'm not afraid of anything that has happened in my past. My conscience is clear because my heart was clean. I didn't do a thing to a soul. So when I came on and I shared with you what I have been through, I also shared with you the experience with a person who was married. And I saw on Facebook where somebody made a post, and right away the Holy Spirit told me that they were talking about me. They made a post and they were criticizing the fact that I had been through that experience and now God was using me. Now tell me something. If you are coming from a state of imperfection to perfection, if that is not to be glorified for God, what is? We are not hiding our testimonies. We are not supposed to hide the testimony. The testimony is supposed to be shared because there are many others like me who may be going through the same thing. And they believe they are not worthy. They believe God cannot use them, and that's a lie from the pit of hell. You must be able to share your testimony so that it will lift others out of the place of darkness. So those of you who say that you are Christians and you come on live and you listen to a testimony and then you criticize where somebody's coming from and use it to try and judge the person now to say, how come God is using you? You're not a Christian. You don't know the word. You're under a religious spirit. You're under a religious spirit. God didn't come for the perfect. He came for the imperfect people so that He could perfect that which concerns you. These are the reasons why many people do not share their testimony. Because they're afraid of what self-righteous people will say. But my word to all of you right now, humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. Cheer for those who God has lifted up. Cheer for those who God has taken out of the pit and put them in the pulpit. When testimonies are shared, be blessed by it. Be inspired by it. Don't come with a religious spirit to criticize and to judge. It's because of the level of maturity that God has allowed me to have why I'm responding in this way. If it was the old me who used to get upset and very sensitive when people say things, I would have gone to that person right away and put them in their place. Now, when you ask the Lord to give you wisdom, He gives you maturity, spiritual wisdom and maturity to handle these things. And that is why I've chosen to share with all of you now in this manner, rather than to go to someone and say, how dare you? No, you can't function like that. You have to rise above that. If God gives you wisdom, use it wisely. Use it. Stay above the fray. Respond in a godly manner. When people criticize you, you're on the journey and they criticize you, respond with godliness. Respond with wisdom. Ask yourself, how would Jesus deal with this? And that is the compass that you use. How would Jesus deal with this? That's the compass you use. Because it's not easy being a pastor. You're going to be criticized. People will say things to hurt your feeling. And you have to bite your tongue and say, Lord, how would you deal with this? Put words in my mouth. Give me wisdom to respond. Give me wisdom to know if I should keep quiet. So I speak a blessing over the person who wrote that comment on Facebook. I have nothing to hide. I want you to buy my book. As a matter of fact, I probably should send you a copy because I want it to bless you. I want it to bless you. Every one of you on this live, in your state of imperfection, God can work on you and use you. Don't let anybody tell you any different. It don't matter how many sins you have, you can be cleansed. When you are saved, you become a new creature. Your sins are washed away. So don't let judgmental people, whether they're in the church or outside the church, stop you from serving God or stop you from thinking that God can use you. He can use you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I pray that you have been inspired. All of you who are watching, I speak a blessing over you as you watch right now in the name of Jesus. I pray that your mind has been renewed. I pray that the blessings of the Lord will be poured out upon you right now. I pray that healing will come to all of you who are struggling with some kind of infirmity. I pray that some of you who are not courageous enough to make that move that you need to make, that the spirit of boldness will come upon you this morning in the name of Jesus. And I pray that the desires of your heart that are according to the will and purpose of God for your life, they shall manifest. They shall come to life. For those of you who are asking about the book, I didn't put it on. I didn't write it in the at the top of the live, but I'll do it in a minute or so. You can go to my website if you want to buy the book, marieburbick.com, and you will find the book. No holds barred. If I know that I can transform somebody's life with my story, I'm going to tell you the story. I'm not going to pretend. But here's a trick. Live clean. Have a clean heart. Because I had a clean heart, I'm okay with telling my story because I know I didn't do anything. For all the things that happened, I'm not saying I'm a saint, but I didn't do anything. So make sure, no matter what you're going through, don't let people pull you out of character with their behavior toward you. Stay true to yourself. And at the end of the day, you can tell your story without guilt. You can tell your story without fear. Purity of the heart is what matters. And God saw that. There was purity of the heart. So all when they might kill you, just stay steadfast. Keep your eyes on God. Because He's going to rescue you. He's going to pull you out. I'm not asking you anything. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. No matter what you're going through, God has an answer and He has a time when He's going to pull you out. I cried for years when I was going through my struggles and on my knees. And God would not release me. Not until it was time. He could not release me before the time because I was being trained. All of that was training. I'm a different person now, the way I do things, the way I see things. But I had to go through those things for my mind to be renewed. Thank you very much, Sister Yamina, for posting the link to buy the book. So don't despise the process you're going through, because that process is preparing you for the promotion. You're gonna come out. And when you come out, you're coming out as pure gold. You're coming out with wisdom, just like me. You think I had all of this wisdom before now? I was intelligent, yes. But when it comes to matters of the spirit, your intelligence cannot take you anywhere. It's the wisdom that comes from God, the spirit of wisdom that helps you. It's not your intelligence and nothing that you learn in college with your master's and your PhD. It's not that. So all of that had to take a back seat. Because no matter how I tried to apply what I learned in college to my situation when I was going through it, it couldn't help me. It would not help me. It was while I was going through all of those things, I learned about the different types of demonic attacks and how to deal with them. It was that time that I learned how to pray prayers of impact. It was during that time that I learned how to understand people who didn't have money. It was during that time that I learned how to apply the word in my life. So don't scorn and don't despise what you're going through. I know it's rough, but God has an opportune time to release you, and he's going to release you when it's time. If he releases you before time, you will not get the lesson. So you will not be able to do what I'm doing. You have to go through the process. You have to do every module. It's like doing a degree. You can't skip out some modules and get the degree. You will not get it. Do all the modules so that you can get the degree and wave your certificate when God is finished. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. This is just me speaking right now as the Holy Spirit is leading me. And I pray that you're learning something from it. Because from the bottom of my heart, I genuinely want to see all of you who are watching me being transformed. I want to see you gain wisdom, understanding. I want to see you be blessed. I don't want to see you on a battlefield and you're fighting an enemy that you don't understand. I don't want to see you on a battlefield and you're fighting with weapons that cannot help you. So that's why I'm here. I'm here to show you. I'm here to enlighten you. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Ah, bless the Lord. Forgive me, people, if I'm just talking. But, you know, as the Holy Spirit pours into me, I just pour it back to you. I just pour it back to you. I'm not on Facebook because I'm trying to deceive anybody. I'm on Facebook because I'm on assignment, and this platform is part of my assignment. Somebody said to me a couple months ago, and I don't think she knew better because she's not where I am spiritually, but she said to me at one point, why do I post the testimonies? She said she didn't think I should post the testimonies. When people get their healing and breakthrough, I shouldn't post it. Now listen to me, people of God. When you are on assignment and God has shown you clearly what your assignment is and how he is going to get you to fulfill that assignment, don't listen to what people out the road come and tell you. A man who is not of the spirit cannot advise you who is of the spirit, because he can't see what you are seeing. He doesn't know your assignment. He doesn't know what God has told you. So when that person came and they said that, even if they meant well, I can't listen to that person because I know my assignment and I know what God has instructed me to do. I must post the testimonies because the testimonies must show people that God exists. It must show people that God still heals. It must show people that God can bring breakthrough. The darkness that people are living in, it must go. We must bring the light so that people can be released from the darkness. The testimonies are the light. So when I come and I share a testimony, it is to show somebody that God is still in control. And even though you not believe in him, if you see two testimony, three testimony, it's not buck up, it's not by accident. You will start to think, oh, maybe God is real. I'm doing my duty. I am executing my assignment. So when man comes and says, don't post the testimony, man don't understand my assignment. They don't know what God has called me to do. I'm doing what God has called me to do. It's not about man, it's about what God says. The price is high, but do it. Do it. Be obedient. Do it. Your reward will come. All right, people of God. Let me see what time it is. I need to get off the live. Oh my God, it's 12:31. I need to get off this live now. Hallelujah. God bless you, Beverly McKay, Charlotte Mitchell, everybody, Trudy Smith, Yolanda Smith, God bless you, Minister, Yamina Maxi, Irene Brady, Lunette Kane, everybody who is watching for the first time, a special welcome and a blessing to you. Karen Wright, God bless you, love you, sweetheart. Tash Nemard, Sweetie, how you doing? God bless you too, sister. As I prepare to leave you, I just want to speak a blessing over you, every one of you. Sister Janet Rose, I love you. Thank you so much. Where is Lydia Grant Simmons? God bless you, sister. I love you. Cassandra, I'm still praying for you. God bless you. I'm still praying for you too. Yolanda, Sister Yolanda, and Sister Yamina, you've been such a blessing to me as well. Audrey Williams, God bless you. Arlene Small, Miriam Shaw, all of you who watch today, I speak a blessing over your life. Sharonda Davis, Delia Henry, Charlotte Mitchell, all of you. Bernadette Moody, all of you who have shared the live. Even though the live is about to end, still share it so somebody can see it who needs it. Somebody needs to be blessed. Shiny Grant, how are you, sister? And Penelope Nixon, God bless you. God bless you. Carol Smith, thank you for all your support of the ministry, Carol. Sandra Donaldson, I don't think I've seen you before, but God bless you. Good to see you. And Angela Forbes, Ingrid Barnett, you have always been there. God bless you. Everton Charlton, it's always good to see the men. Hyacinth Bennett, good to see you. Jacqueline Green Samuels, I speak a blessing over you, all of you who are watching. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty God. Share your testimonies. Jasmine Barron, God bless you, sister. I'm going to leave you now. But I want to remind you, in your state of imperfection, God can use you. Paul persecuted God's people when he was Saul, but God used him. And you know what his legacy is in the New Testament. You're not too soiled for God to use you. Don't watch man, don't care what man says, because at the end of the day, when you need help, when you cry out, it's God who is going to answer you. Many people are going to turn their backs against you. Yes. It is God who is going to be there for you, not man. I can't tell you some things. Some of my testimonies, they are too dangerous. But I'm just telling you that the power of God is alive and well. And when you develop that relationship with him and God begins to move in your life, you will be amazed. You will be shocked. You are protected. No weapon formed against you will prosper when God is covering you. I'm telling you because I have been through it. I have had men, I said it before, I've had men on assignment to kill me. They were paid to kill me. And the same men who were paid to kill me, they told somebody that they couldn't kill me. I saw them at times. I didn't know who they were, but I knew I was being followed. They followed my car. They drove past my house several times. They drove behind me on the street because they were given orders to kill me. But the power of God was so great. Angels were on assignment around me that those boys couldn't shoot me. They couldn't. No matter how they tried, they couldn't shoot me. They came back and said they couldn't shoot me. They take the money and never did the job. My late bishop was the one who called me from the United States at the time I was in Jamaica and said to me, there's a light around you. I didn't tell him nothing that was going on. He said, the men who are trying to kill you cannot kill you. Because every time they look at you, there's a light around you, so they cannot kill you. And the guys come back and said they couldn't kill me. They said they couldn't shoot me. See me here? Me alive today. Same way. They came back and asked if I wanted them to kill the person who sent them to kill me. That's what they asked. They took the money, didn't kill me, and then sent message to me asking if I wanted them to turn it around. If I wanted them to go back and kill the person who wanted to kill me. I'm telling you, my testimonies are dangerous. Dangerous. I am a walking miracle. They couldn't do a thing. They came and asked me if I want them to go back and kill the person. But because of my heart, I couldn't do that. You have to use wisdom too. When God has you an assignment, when he's preparing you for something, you cannot abort that assignment by doing something stupid that the enemy is setting you up for. Right away I saw through it. When they came back and sent the message to me, if I wanted them to kill the person who sent them to kill me, I saw the plan of the enemy right away, which was to have me end up in prison. Because if I had done that, I would have been found out and me would be in jail now. I wouldn't have any testimony. I wouldn't be ordained. I wouldn't be preaching anything to you. So you have to use wisdom and see the traps of the enemy. You have to see when the enemy is planning against you. I saw it. And I said, no way. Besides, that's not me. That's not my heart. I can't kill nobody. But the devil is a liar. Some of you, the things that are coming before you, like they are solutions to your problems, they are traps. Ask the Lord to give you insight. They are traps. They are not from God. It's traps. The enemy trying to set you up to abort the purpose over your life. So you have to ask God for the spirit of discernment. Not everything that comes to you looking good is of God. It's not God. The enemy also sending answers to your problems. You have to know. You have to be able to discern. Hallelujah. So when the enemy comes in at you like a flood, God will lift up a standard against them. God has had to lift up a standard against my enemies many times. Many times. One of the times I saw in the realms of the spirit where I was running through a tunnel. I was running through a dark tunnel in the realms of the spirit. And it's like inside the tunnel were fires. But I saw myself run through the fires, straight through the fires, and go straight through the tunnel and come out on the other side. In the realms of the spirit, that's what I saw. A dark tunnel with some fires in it. And I ran through all the fires in the tunnel and came straight out at the back without even a burn. Not a burn. And my bishop called me, maybe 2 days later. And he said, woman of God, I heard in the realms of the spirit, where is like the enemy questioning. He's saying, how did you make it? Despite all the traps he set for you, how did you make it? So you see what I'm saying? When God shows you something, he will send somebody to confirm. I saw myself run through the fires in the tunnel, come out on the other end without one burn on my body. And then my bishop called me 2 days later and said he heard. The enemy amazed, like, how did she come through? How did she come through? This is what God will do for you when you trust him. When you hold on to his hands and trust him completely. Don't let nobody tell you that God is not real. You got to know him for yourself. Develop that relationship and you will see the hand of God in your life in the same way that I saw it. Anyway, God bless you everybody. I've said enough for today. And I pray that it has enlightened your life and that it will bless you. As you go through the rest of the day, just meditate on what I've shared with you. And I pray that transformation will take place in your life. God bless you, everybody. Love you.